Hello, in this video I'll be discussing how to create a simple Qt Widgets application using Qt for Python. Before watching this, make sure you are familiar with the basics of Python and have installed PySide6 in a virtual environment. If you have not done this, we have another video which explains how to do this. I'll be creating a relatively simple application which takes a string from the user and appends it to a text edit when a button is clicked, as shown here. I'll be writing this program in Qt Creator, so if you want to do the same, you'll need to make sure you have a Python executable included as one of your external tools. To do this, go to Edit, Preferences, Environment, and External Tools. Then add the Python executable by adding a new Python category and a new tool under that category. Then point the executable category to your Python executable, as shown here. You'll also want to add the current document file path and the current document path to the argument and working directory, respectively. With that done, we're ready to create our Qt for Python project. To do this, we'll go to File, New Project. From here, select Application Qt for Python, then select Empty Application and click Choose. Next, we'll need to create a name and location for our project. So I will call my project Python Widgets app. You can then select a location for your project to be saved. I will leave this as default, but feel free to change this as you would like. Then click Next. Next, we'll be prompted to define our project details. I will keep this as PySide6, but you can select other versions here if needed. Finally, we come to the summary page. Nothing needs to be changed here, but you can see a list of files that will be created and where they will be saved. Since this all looks good, I'll click Finish. Now you can see our Python project has been created. So let's take a quick look at the generated files. First, we have our .py project file. This only has three lines which indicate which files our project is made up of. In this case, the only file we have is the main.py file. However, if you need to add additional files to your project, this is where you would add them to ensure they are included in your project. The only other file generated is the main.py file, seen here. This file contains some import statements from PySide6 as well as sets up our main, which is the entrance to our application. To start, we'll need to make some changes to these imports in order to create our Qt Widgets GUI. So I will add from PySide6 import Qt Core, Qt Widgets, and Qt GUI. This will give us access to the Qt libraries needed to create our GUI. With that done, the first thing we need to do is create a class which inherits from Qt Widget. So I'll add the following. Class MyWidget QtWidgets.QWidget. Then we'd like to make this class self-referential, so I'll add def init self, and finally we'd like to avoid explicitly referring to the base class, so I'll add super dot init. We now have an empty class which inherits from Qt Widget. Before we flush this class out, let's initialize it in our main. So I'll add app equals Qt Widget dot Q application. Then I'll add widget equals my widget, initializing our class, and I'll give it a size of widget dot resize, and we'll make it 800 by 600 pixels. And finally, we'll say widget.show, which will force our window to show up on the screen. To see what this looks like, we can go ahead and run our application. As you can see, we now have a window of the specified size, and any components we add to the MyWidget class will be displayed in this window. So we can begin fleshing out our class. First, I'll add a button to my class by adding the code self.button equals Qt Widgets dot Q push button, and I'll give the button some text, which will read click to display text. I will then add a line edit with some placeholder text by adding the code self.line underscore edit equals Qt Widgets dot Q line edit. And I'll add the placeholder text with the line self.line underscore edit dot set placeholder text. And this will read enter to append text. And finally, I'll create a text edit by adding the code self dot text underscore edit equals Qt Widgets dot Q text edit. We now have all our components. However, none of them will be displayed in the window yet, as they have not been added to a layout. So next, we'll need to create a vertical box layout component and add our three components to this layout by adding the following code. Self dot layout equals Qt Widgets dot Q V box layout and give it self. Then we'll add our line edit component to this by typing self dot layout dot add widget self dot line underscore edit. I can now copy this line two more times to add the other components to the layout as well by simply changing the parameter in the add widget function. So I'll replace self dot line edit with self dot button and the other one with self dot text edit. Now, if we run our application, you can see we have our components displayed in the window. However, our button is not yet functional. As you can see, nothing happens when we click it. In order to add functionality to this button, we will need to create a slot and connect the button clicked signal up to this slot. To do this, let's first create a slot by adding the code at qtcore dot slot def magic and give it self. This slot will contain the functionality we want to happen whenever the button is clicked. Since I would like to append the text edit with the text in the line edit when the button is clicked, I will add the following code to the slot. Self dot text underscore edit dot append self dot line underscore edit dot text. Now, all we need to do is connect up the button clicked signal to this slot and we should be good to go. So, inside the MyWidget class, I will add the code self.button.clicked.connect self.magic. With this added, all the code that's inside the slot will be executed when we press the button. So, we should be ready to test our application. So, let's click run. As you can see, when we enter some text in the line edit and click the button, the text is appended in the text edit. And we can change the text and we can append the new text as well. You now have a functioning Qt Widget application working with PySide6. If you ran into any issues getting this working, feel free to create a support request through your Qt account, and we will be happy to help you resolve your issue. Thank you.